Now it's time to split our data into training data and testing data. I kind of like to think about this like an exam. Training data is like a practice exam. The questions aren't exactly the same as they are going to be on the test, but if you practice and you get those right, you're more likely to get test questions right. Similarly, the model will use the training data to learn, and then we'll send the testing data to the model and it'll try to predict. We will compare the predictions from the model with the testing data to score it, just like an instructor might use an exam key to see how well you did on an exam. So let's get started splitting our data between training data and testing data. As always, additional resources are linked on the screen and down in the description below. This is actually fairly simple inside of a Jupyter notebook. We're going to create a local variable called train, and this will be all of our data from before August 31st, 2012, inclusive of that date. And to make it easy to work with, we're going to convert that into a Pandas data frame. Now, why did we choose August 31st? Well, if we look back at our data, we can see that it starts on January 1st, 2011, and we have data from every single day until December 31st, 2012. So by choosing August 31st, 2012, we're choosing 75% of our data to be used as our training set. Basically, we just want to take the other 25% and save that for our testing set. Let's run this cell to verify that the last five rows of this data frame are the last 5 days of August 2012. This looks right. Now for our testing data, we're essentially going to do the same thing, but this time we're going to start at September 1st, 2012, and we want to be inclusive of that boundary as well. Notice that we've changed a couple of things here. One is that we want all of the rows after the date September 1st, 2012, versus in our training data, we wanted all of the dates before. And we're also going to print the first five rows of this data frame rather than the last five to make sure that we're getting the first 5 days of September. This is looking good. It looks like we've got our training data and our testing data ready to go.